Vacuum-operated fuel valve. The valve diaphragm is supported by a spring and does not allow fuel to pass further. Each time, during the first stroke, when the intake phase occurs, a vacuum is created in the intake tract. This vacuum travels through the vacuum line to the fuel valve. The fuel, under the influence of atmospheric pressure, bends the diaphragm and flows freely to the carburetor. If the carburetor is empty, the float is in the lower position. The fuel fills the float chamber. As the chamber fills, the float rises and lifts the needle valve. When the required fuel level is reached, the needle blocks the fuel supply. During the intake phase, atmospheric air moves toward the cylinder. This is the idle air passage. There are three small exhaust ports located below the throttle valve. The main mixture supply channel for idling operation is adjusted by a screw. Communication channel between the float chamber and atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure pushes on the fuel. The fuel, through the idle jet, moves into the low pressure zone. It mixes with air and moves into the cylinder. In addition to the idle channels, there is also a starter enrichment channel. It provides additional fuel-air mixture supply to facilitate engine startup and warm-up. When the engine is cold, the enrichment needle is raised. Atmospheric air moves toward the cylinder. At the same time, the vacuum from the enrichment channel extends to the intake tube. Remember that fuel in the float chamber is constantly under atmospheric pressure. The fuel moves into the low pressure zone. Under the needle, the fuel mixes with air and moves into the cylinder. After the engine starts, the voltage generated by the alternator is supplied to the starter enrichment valve. It takes approximately 4 minutes for the valve to shut off the fuel supply. After the throttle valve is opened, the vacuum spreads further. Through the hole at the bottom of the air valve, the vacuum enters the valve cavity. Atmospheric pressure, which enters through the arc-shaped opening, pushes on the diaphragm. Thus, the air valve and the needle rise together. The vacuum enters the main fuel supply channel. Gasoline from the float chamber, under the influence of atmospheric pressure, is pushed through the main fuel jet. Atmospheric air moves toward the low pressure zone through the air jet. Through holes in the mixing tube, air enters the gasoline. Next, the fuel mixture is sprayed into the mixing chamber and drawn into the intake trap. After the throttle valve is closed, atmospheric air quickly fills the air valve cavity. The spring returns the air valve to its lower position. The needle blocks the main fuel channel. Accelerator pump. It injects a portion of gasoline when the throttle valve is suddenly opened. Through a miniature hole in the lower cover of the float chamber, gasoline enters under the accelerator pump diaphragm. When the plunger is pressed, the diaphragm pushes gasoline in the pump. If the plunger is pressed sharply, gasoline from the pump cannot immediately escape through the small hole. Therefore, gasoline looks for an exit from the pump. This exit is the fuel injection channel into the mixing chamber. Gasoline pressure pushes on the valve ball, overcoming the spring force, and moves up the channel. As soon as the gasoline pressure equalizes, the spring returns the ball back. The diaphragm also returns to its original position under the influence of the spring. At the same time, a new portion of gasoline from the float chamber enters the pump. This carburetor also has an idle stabilization system that works after the throttle is suddenly closed. When the engine runs at idle, air reaches the idle jet not only through the air jet, but also through the air channel that comes from above and passes through a special valve. This valve remains open at all times. The valve is controlled by an air channel connected to the carburetor outlet. If the throttle valve is suddenly closed, the fuel mixture supply is abruptly reduced. However, the crankshaft is still rotating at high RPM. The engine requires more fuel to run. Additionally, the vacuum force increases significantly. Atmospheric pressure overcomes the valve spring force. The diaphragm bends in the opposite direction. The valve's shutoff element, under the influence of its own spring, closes the air channel. The additional air supply stops. This leads to an increase in the amount of fuel coming from the idle jet. This is necessary to avoid misfires after suddenly closing the throttle valve. When the engine RPM and vacuum decrease, the spring returns the valve diaphragm to its original position. Additional air is once again supplied to the idle jet. This reduces the amount of gasoline during idle operation. Three most common fuel system problems I have encountered. One, fuel valve diaphragm rupture. Symptom: when trying to ride at full throttle, the engine stalls. If the throttle is released while riding, the engine continues to run. Typically, the rupture is minor and the diaphragm only leaks at high engine RPMs. That is, if the vacuum hose is removed, no fuel stream will be visible. At best, only a few drops will appear. This is an indication that the fuel valve needs to be replaced. At low engine speeds, everything may work fine. But when the engine reaches maximum RPM, the diaphragm starts to leak fuel. As a result, at high RPM, the engine floods with fuel and stalls. Two, debris under the float needle valve. When debris enters, the needle cannot block the fuel supply, causing overflow. The fuel level rises, increasing the amount of fuel supplied through the idle channel. Gasoline begins to leak spontaneously through the air jet of the main fuel channel. The air filter becomes soaked with gasoline. A wet filter element obstructs airflow and causes excessive vacuum between the filter and the carburetor. This, in turn, leads to even more fuel leakage into the filter cavity. In this condition, the engine will not start. After cleaning the carburetor, the air filter should also be dried or replaced if wet. Three, starter enrichment seal ring. One of the causes of poor idle operation is the wear of the rubber ring in the mounting seat. Although the cylindrical shutoff element blocks the outlet channel, there is still a gap between the housing wall and the moving part of the valve. If the rubber ring is not airtight, excess air enters the engine intake. This significantly leans the mixture at idle. Sometimes, the engine simply stops running. I check the condition of the seal as follows. If the solenoid valve rotates easily in its mounting seat, the seal ring needs replacement. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next videos.